Doom 64 as well. Finally, we've got the Crucible, a weapon they first showed up in one of the earliest gameplay reveals. Now, this is a weapon made from Argent Energy, and it just kind of looks like a bloody giant laser sword. It kind of works like the chainsaw from Doom 2016, and then it can one-shot almost every single demon, with a preset animation showing them getting sliced in half. It uses Argent Energy from pickups you find throughout the levels. Each demon takes one charge to kill, and you've got a total of three charges all up. An elegant weapon for a more civilized age. Like I said before, each weapon has its own strengths and weaknesses. I mean, a rocket launcher is good against an Incubus, for instance, but little use against the Whiplash, who'll just outright dodge it. Whereas a plasma rifle might be good against Revenants or Imps, it's not as useful against the Baron of Hell, who soaks up those plasma rifle rounds like it's low-carbohydrate craft beer. Up against an armored Pinky Demon or a Spectre, well, throw out an Ice Bomb and then shoot him in the ass. Enjoy the view too while you're back there, King. Swapping between weapons on the fly is pretty much essential, as each weapon works for better or worse against the demon type. All I can say too is just make sure you stay hydrated and take breaks every 30 or 40 minutes, because this shit is intense. I feel like they need some kind of support group that players can join after they stop playing this to help them assimilate back into everyday life. Yeah, the whole thing's pretty hardcore. By the end of the game, I think I had what could only be described as a 1,000-yard stare. Level design is also pretty good too, and to mix things up, the flow of the levels changes quite a bit. Some of them are a bit more straightforward, without too much delineation off the beaten path, but then others are a lot more open-ended and allow for exploration and secret hunting. Just think of the Foundry from Doom 2016 and it's all no more. There's just a whole heap of secret stuff to find in this game too, and hunting it all down is as much fun as it is making a demon eat their own arm. Instead of having to do rune challenges, now you just find runes in the environment and then they're good to go once equipped. In lieu of this, you've got these things called random encounters where a bunch of demons spawn in.